Welcome. Today the church celebrates the memorial of Peter Chrysologus, Bishop and Doctor of the Church. Our presider today is Father Carlos.
God is in his holy place, God who unites those who dwell in his house. He himself gives might and strength to his people.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Very dear brothers and sisters, before celebrating this sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins, and ask the Lord for forgiveness and compassion. You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made the bishops and Peter Chrysologus as an outstanding preacher of your incarnate word, grant through his intercession that we may constantly ponder in our hearts the mysteries of your salvation and faithfully express them in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. This word came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Rise up, be off to the potter's house. There I will give you my message. I went down to the potter's house, and there he was working at the wheel. Whenever the object of clay which he was making turned out badly in his hand, he tried again, making of the clay another object of whatever sort he pleased. Then the word of the Lord came to me. Can I not do to you, house of Israel, as this potter has done, says the Lord? Indeed, like clay in the hand of the potter, so are you in my hand, house of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God while I live.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Put not your trust in princes, in the sons of men in whom there is no salvation. When his spirit departs, he returns to his earth. On that day, his plans perish.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed he whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Father, your blessing.
May the Lord be in your mind and in your heart, and may you worthily announce the Holy Gospel in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Open our hearts, O Lord, to listen to the words of your Son.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit. With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." "Do you understand these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." When Jesus finished these parables, he went away from there. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's Gospel, it is a scene about judgment. But in Jesus' parable, it is more clear about the judgment that he's talking about. When you go fishing and you use a pole to fish, you can catch something and you may not want that fish and you can throw it back and try again. But when you fish with a net, you get the fish that you want plus many other fish and other things that happen to get caught up in the net. And so you aren't as lucky or as fortunate to get just what you are looking for. And Jesus is telling us that is what it is like with our mission as disciples of him, as well as what we are called to do. We can't always get those people who we want to get. We, in a way, judge who we are getting the message to. That we may look at someone and go, "Well, no, they're really not worth my time, and I'm not going to preach the good news to them." Or, "That individual seems like they get it, and I want to talk to them so that they can get the message." We aren't called to judge, and Jesus is telling us that today. That is not our responsibility. Our responsibility as baptized Christians, as baptized Catholics, as brothers and sisters in Christ, sons and daughters of God the Father, as missionaries, is to cast our nets to bring in everything. And then as we bring them in, then leave it to God to make the choice or to help them learn more about him. We are not called to judge, even though many times we may do that ourselves, or we know of individuals who judge based on their own perception of what God is looking for or how we are to live our own lives. So Jesus is saying, leave that to the end of the age, when the angels will come and they will go out and separate the good from the bad. And they will do as they are instructed to either destroy the bad, send them off to the wailing and grinding of teeth, or to eternal glory with God the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
It is difficult to not be judgmental, but it is what we are called to be, as not being the judges and leaving the judgment to God, the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit. Trusting in the Lord who told Solomon, "Ask something of me and I will give it to you," we now call to mind our needs and the needs of our neighbors around the world and address them to our generous and caring God. For the church, that we may realize the treasure of God's presence buried in each person we meet and live our lives in the joy of that knowledge, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For political leaders, that they may govern the vast and diverse people in their care with wise and understanding hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a deeper appreciation of our seas, oceans, and waterways as a valuable source of life, and for more enlightened approaches to the use of these resources, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an awareness of the preciousness of life from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those who care for them, that they know the compassionate love of Jesus, especially Baby Barrett Rinklin, Deacon Ed Moser, Deacon Rick Pomfrey, Thomas Didia, Gabby Short, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Barry Grimes, for whom this Mass is being offered, and all victims of war and violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of this Mass, for the repose of the soul of Gertrude Vanduhar, Bill Suda, John Haggerty, Ron Beckman, and John Anderson, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the petitions written in our Book of Petitions and all the intentions we hold faithfully in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Generous God, you formed us in your own image, showered us with your love, and granted us your forgiveness, treasures beyond compare. Help us to share these gifts with one another. Grant this in all our prayers through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For to your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work in human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For to your goodness we have received this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work in human hands, it will become a spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed Peter Chrysologus, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just to give you thanks and to raise to you a hymn of glory and praise, O Lord, Father of infinite goodness, for by the word of your Son's gospel, you have brought together one church from every people, tongue, and nation, and having filled her with life by the power of your Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. Manifesting the covenant of your love, he dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope for your kingdom and shines bright as the sign of your faithfulness, which in Christ Jesus our Lord you promised would last for eternity. And so with all the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, while with all the church as one voice we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst, when you are gathered by his love, and as one for the disciples and all for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, more merciful, we ask that you send for your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing. Broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion unto the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at the right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church in which offer the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and granted by the power of your Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Lord, renew your church which is in San Diego by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the people and the pastors of your people. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection into the fullness of life. Grant also to us on our earthly pilgrimages done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed George, her spouse, with the apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Peter Chrysologus and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Gathering our prayer and praises into one, let us pray in the same word Jesus Christ, our Savior, taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, and earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The
peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am no worthy that you enter under my roof,
but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all his benefits.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of Blessed Peter Chrysologus, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice that he taught. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.